Hello friends, today's video is a seed saving video and I'm going to share with you another method of saving those brinjal or eggplant seeds. I had shared my method of saving eggplant seeds, my first method 2 years ago, and you can watch that video. I'll give the link in the description box and in the pinned comment, and that is my most favorite method because I have to do nothing. Now for this method, I tried another method just to see how it goes and everything. So as usual, you have to take a brinjal or an eggplant that has ripened on the plant. So these two eggplants were light in color and they turned completely yellow. Now for a darker eggplant, I'm not sure if they turn yellow. If any of you have saved those black or purple eggplants, do let me know if they become yellow, or how do you know that the seeds are ready to be saved. Now this method I saw on YouTube on another channel called Living Traditions Homestead, and it's a wonderful channel that I love to watch. Now they were saving seeds for Baker Creek. I'm grating the eggplant or the brinjal from the biggest slot on the grater, and after I'm done, I'll put the entire pulp into a bowl of water and kind of gently massage the entire pulp so that the seeds and the pulp separate. The pulp being lighter, it will float, and the good seeds that are viable, the ones that will germinate, they will sink to the bottom. Any seeds that are not viable, they will float. So I'll leave this alone for around half an hour or 40 minutes to allow the pulp and the seeds to separate out, and then what you do is you just remove off all the pulp from the top, and that can go into the composting system, or if you want to make some pancakes or some kind of chila or something, it can be used. And just wash off the seeds very nicely, dry them out on a sieve in a cool and dark place, not in sunlight, inside the house, any well ventilated area. And once they are dry, you can pack them up in a wrap, a paper wrap or a tissue paper, and then I put them inside a Ziploc and store them in the refrigerator. And that is the best way to store seeds for Mumbai weather. If you want to use a glass bottle to store those seeds, that's even better. I don't have that much space in my refrigerator to have glass jars for so many seeds that I have in my collection. So I use a Ziploc because it saves space and it's very convenient. Now what I would do differently if I had to do this again is I would take a much bigger container of water so that there was enough buoyancy in that bowl or the container so that the grated soft parts would float easily. In here I had to kind of go through the process 2-3 times because the bowl was very small, and I realized my mistake in hindsight. And I had to repeat the process, add water again, kind of move it around, and then wait for some more time. So it took me around an hour and a half to get the whole thing done. If there are a lot of brinjals that you are processing to save seeds, then what I saw in the video from Living Traditions Homestead is instead of grating, they used the grater blade of the food processor. This is another way, but after using both methods, I just loved my first method where I just placed that ripened brinjal in a container with potting mix, and I let the soft parts kind of compost, and I'm just left with clean seeds with no effort at all on my part. So do watch that video. If any of you have tried this method, do let me know how you find it, and you can see my other seed saving videos. I'll put the playlist link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. Happy seed saving.